Hey guys and gals, it's me, Sash, of course, with, as always, my broken English. Anyway, we finally reached the moment when I'm going to review my favorite weapon in all games that are available, the F2020 for Ghost in the Shell Standalone Complex First Assault Online. Anywhere else calls like F2000 in GRP. And in real life, FN2000. I know this weapon have been nerfed, not recently, but have been nerfed with one of the latest patch. But I don't care, I'm still playing with F2020 whenever I have a chance. Because I really enjoy of this weapon and suits me pretty well for CQC and some other situations. Anyway, let's watch the video. Well, in general, there is not much to talk about this weapon. I have tried several attachment combinations to see which one suits me best. Most of the time, I'm happy to play with this weapon in CQC, even though managed to use on range shooting, but not meant to be a range weapon, especially after the second nerf of this weapon. Okay, as I said, there is not much to talk about the weapon, so I don't know why till now I've managed to get in the armory according to my video script. Starting with F2020 is a higher fire rate weapon, even higher fire rate than Saburo C30. And that's from where the strength of F2020 comes from. Accurate assault rifle with higher fire rate. Higher fire rate weapon does not mean only a wall to shoot rapidly compared to AK-47, but also means wall recoil spread pattern. The faster you shoot bullets, the less chunky recoil you have. Speaking about fire rate, I've noticed something interesting while testing F2020 in a shooting range. While trying to perform a single shot firing by tap shooting, I've got 2 bullets per shot almost every time. I don't know if this is by a purpose or if it's not the secret of the weapon. Probably it's due to fire rate. Leave a comment and let me know what you think. Well, let's finally start with the attachment overview. Starting with sight. FMRDS is actually my favorite scope all around, even than Saburo C30 Default 1. On whichever other weapon I have as a choice, FMRDS, I would select it for CQC sight attachment. This scope have the most thin frame and it does not mess with your viewing while cornering. I won't bother to use any other scope. So far I have seen people using KHIHS, I guess to manage for both CQC and range shooting, since KHIHS is zoomed scope. Also quick point S2 I have seen also popular as a choice on F2020. But I wanna repeat myself again, this review is not a general review, it's a review based on my own experience and preferences. Muzzle. The most interesting thing about F2020 is that since it's assault rifle, and as we know, assault rifles are very accurate compared to other weapons type, F2020 is a higher fire rate and accurate weapon. The accuracy amount can get up to 81, and having such accuracy, it's comparable sniper rifle wall range range. In shooting range, no issue of getting headshot on further distance target in hip fire. Of course, MB58L as muzzle. If you don't know the reason, check out my AK-47 gun review where I have explained in details. Magazine. It does not matter what I have said previously, for F2020 you have to go with dual A1 magazine. This weapon have a higher fire rate and you go empty pretty quickly. Even though the damage it's not so high and you may have to manage to get more bullets in the target. Bipod. Well, about bipod, I'm playing without in most cases, as I would like to have faster swap time and faster movement speed. But it's up to you, and in some cases, which I'm gonna describe later, you can also have a bipod as attachment. Aim assist. To be honest, for aim assist I have hesitated for a while between KBY-11 and SOC-1. Both are quite similar in terms of stats. Both serve to accuracy increase by having only amount of 1 accuracy differences. And having SOC-1, your movement speed drops by only 1 compared to KBY-11 with -2. But that's not all. I have similar preference about having range CBC 1 as aim assist the same as what I prefer on Subaru C30 since F2020 is also designed for CQC engagement. Check out my Subaru C30 gun review for more details featured at the end of this video. Barrel. I have almost forgot it since I'm only using 2511-LB as only barrel since damage increase. I won't bother to use anything else on F2020 and also on other certain weapons. Maybe 2001-basic make exception, but only for team deathmatch. But I don't think playing for just +2 more stability justifying enough the expense of GP price as overall attachment set for F2020. Well, it seems like I have say a why at the beginning by saying there is nothing so much to say about F2020, but seems like there is. And because I forgot to make a disclaimer and we're still on a similar topic, all data of this video are gathered from open beta stage of the game before 2.0 update. All stats are a subject of a change in a future update. Recommendations. For the time being, I'll recommend F2020 to people who play more CQC for maps and game mods that have more CQC situations in the following attachment combinations: FMRDS Scope SOC-1 as aim assist for faster movement speed compared to KBY-11, or range CBC-1 for damage increase, 2511-LB for barrel, MB58L for muzzle attachment, and dual A1 magazine. I'm playing with these attachment combinations for TDM and some demolition maps like Geofront. For Terminal Conquest and some demolition maps, I like to play F2020 with the following attachment combination of FMRDS KBY-11, 2511-LB, MB58L, dual A1, and even pick a bipod, since most of the time you don't rewind to swap your weapon quickly and gameplay is related to covering a small area in Terminal Conquest or slow-paced gameplay for Demolition, where most of the time you are playing from cover and range engagement. For Demolition maps, I also do exchange MB58L with OPS 1S suppressor for more stealthy approach. One more time, I would like to mention I would make a gun reviews only on a weapons I have and also playing with. Whenever I got a new one, I will review after get enough experience with. But don't expect me to do as what I did in GRP. Back then was different since new weapons pack was available first at the exclusive store, then available to all players after certain time. As always, I hope you enjoy and find this video useful. Otherwise, I don't know what else to say except thanks for watching. No, the video haven't finished yet. Otherwise, how can I make you watch the whole video? Except you're not skipped to the end. But anyway, we have to select the giveaway winner from Subaru C30 gun review video. For this purpose, I will use the very popular YouTube random comment picker. In case you don't know what is this, check out the video's description. Will be linked down below. Just simply open the YouTube random comment picker. Copy and paste the YouTube video link and press the button for randomly pick winner. Congratulations to the winner who will receive the redeem code via YouTube message. Anyway, since I set my video closer, I will close this video awkwardly. Same as what I did last time with Seburo C30 video, being noticed by Chen Shai. I guess my pronounce wasn't correct. Let me know by leave a comment below.